Okay, so I have a very quick answer to a question that somebody over there just asked me. We're standing up on the, I don't know where we are. We're in Costa Rica.
Right.
So anyways, here's the question. It was, what's the difference between exogenous ketones or ketones? Here, throw me some ketones. Throw me my lid. Okay. What's the difference between these or getting your liver to make ketones? You didn't have to zoom in on my stomach. Getting your liver to make ketones. It's really, 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 really easy. It's usually from like a cynical health and wellness person, some dietitian, doctor, somebody that took medical school 32 years ago and they know this much about ketones or maybe ketoacidosis or whatever. So I just want to clear up one of the really, really, really simple things. This is pure ketones. These are ketone bodies. Your liver either makes them as a defense mechanism to keep you from dying, because if you go no carb, no sugar, in either high fat or high protein, your liver will make ketones. Your liver makes them, or you do this. You drink them. The end result is ketosis. Ketosis is defined specifically as a heightened level of blood ketones in your body. That's what ketosis is. Ketogenesis, it means your liver made the ketones. Ketosis, again, is a heightened level of blood ketones. Ketogenesis, or nutritional ketosis, means through diet and nutrition, high fat or high protein, no carb, no sugar, or starvation, like if we strapped you to one of these trees and we gave you water every day but no food, your liver in a day or two or three would start making ketones. The end result is ketosis. Drinking this, once again, is ketosis. So one of the things people ask is like, well, what's the difference? How do you know that your body's using the ketones? How do you know you're not just peeing them out? And they ask all these silly questions only from ignorance. They just don't know yet. I didn't know either 2 years ago. I didn't know what a ketone was, different from a Keystone beer. But here's what I can tell you. And whenever Rocky was filmed, what did Rocky drink? Like, think about this for a minute. Remember when he was preparing for his fight? He took a bunch of raw eggs and just drank the eggs. Why? For protein. Because 40 years ago when that movie was filmed, nobody had made a protein bar yet. Don't you think he would have just ripped open a protein bar? Think about Popeye. He's eating spinach. Think about all the things over the last 100 years that people would eat as a way to get protein into their body, like before a fight or whatever it was, or to recover. And then Metrix creates a shake. And then Power Bar. Remember Power Bar? Those weird-tasting, awful-looking bars? Like, that was the first protein bar. But 50 years ago, if you'd have told somebody you can eat a bar, like a candy bar, like a Mars bar, but it's full of protein, they'd have been like, what the hell are you talking about? Today, if you go to Whole Foods, there's an entire line of them. You used to have to eat real food to get protein in your body. You used to have to eat real food to get creatine in your body. You used to have to eat real food to get vitamin C in your body, or any vitamin or any mineral for that matter. GNC used to not exist because people used to eat real food. Now they don't. So all the crap that you used to get, vitamins, minerals, proteins, creatines, things like that, whatever the heck else. I'm not a dietitian. I don't need to be to know this. It's real simple. GNC exists because people don't eat real food. You get all these cynical, holier-than-thou biohacker geeks that are like, well, why would I drink exogenous ketones when my liver will make them? I can just not eat carbs and sugar, and I can stay in the ketosis naturally all the time. Congratulations. Yes, you can. But why does any vitamin shop exist ever? Why does any protein drink exist ever? I could just grill a chicken out in the parking lot of the local gym. I can defeather them and skin them and bust them up and eat them up. Like, why do you have to have a protein shake? You don't. You don't. You don't need any supplement because you can just eat real food. That's why we have ketones. If you just don't eat carbs and don't eat sugar for the rest of your life, your liver will make ketones. It will. I don't want to live that way. Why do you think for 100 years none of your friends are in a state of ketosis for any period of time, ever? So we have an exogenous ketone. You drink it. You pour it into your mouth. If you have a functioning esophagus, try to say that three times, a functioning esophagus, if you drink liquid and it goes into your body, it will go into your bloodstream, it will go into your brain, it will cross through the blood-brain barrier real fast, and you'll feel what it's like to have ketones as an energy source. That's what exogenous ketones are. So, look, I'm super amped at the moment. I'm standing here shirtless, I don't know, on the top of a mountain in Costa Rica surrounded by a bunch of muscular fitness people. So it's not a tough concept to understand. It would be like, it would literally be like saying to a caveman, think about this, you're the caveman in this context, just so you know. It would be like going to a caveman who's holding literally two sticks, two twigs, and he's getting ready to start shimmying them and shucking them together to create a spark to make a fire. And then you roll up on him holding your Keto OS, and you got a lighter, and you're like, I wish I had a lighter. Wham! And there's a flame. And then the caveman is like, ah! You ever seen Encino Man with Pauly Shore? Ah! How did that happen? And he's holding two sticks, and you're trying to sell him on how the fire works. You think your liver has to make ketones by starving it of glucose? You don't. Any more than Rocky drank eggs to get protein into his body. It's not any different. It's 2017. Most people are stuck in 1300s version of ketosis or 1940s version of ketosis, which is don't eat carbs, don't eat sugar, live a diet and a lifestyle that America is incapable of living. Not the holier-than-thou dietitian living in San Diego who hadn't had a carb since 1998 and who eats absolutely perfect. Give me a break. The soda water you had at the wedding the other day mixed with the vodka tonic, it wasn't organic, just so you know. It's fun how people pick and choose what's organic and what isn't. But what I'm telling you is you have the ability to drink pure ketones. So my purpose of the video is not to get amped or be rude. It's to just give you a different perspective that this might be good for you. This might be really, really good for somebody that you care about. But if we can't get through the arrogance and the ignorance of being stuck in what you think ketosis is or isn't, there's a difference. Ketosis, just the word ketosis, means you have a heightened level of blood ketones. It means you have ketone bodies coursing through your body. And there's only a couple ways to get them. And if there's 100 Americans, or I got a bunch of Australians, if there's 100 Australians, 2 out of 100 are capable of living any significant period of time without eating carbs and sugar. Because the minute you eat a banana, bang, you're out of ketosis. You start from scratch, like climbing the mountain again. You have the ability to pour ketones into your system on demand, almost like an instantaneous ketosis. But it's important to understand the difference. There's some facts and there's some fiction. Ketones are ketones are ketones, whether your liver made them or you drank them. They are. Ask your brain. But so many people's teeny little understanding about ketosis is because they took 10 minutes in medical school or they listened to a class in their fitness training course 9 years ago before they got hired at Bally's or whatever. And all that they know is this frame of reference that your liver has to make ketones. It doesn't anymore. Then you have to eat a chicken in order to get some protein. But yet, every gym in every country in the world is selling protein, they're selling creatine, and they're selling vitamins. You can now get you're consuming exogenous protein all the time. You're consuming all kinds of exogenous vitamins and minerals and things like that, just not ketones. So the last thing I'll tell you is if you're not in the ketosis business and you're still in the protein business, it's like being in the VHS business. It's like being literally in the VHS business. It's like being in the landline business. It's like investing in a Blockbuster. I'm just telling you. Ketosis as a supplement is like Uber 5 years ago. It's innovative and nobody that you know has ever heard of it. Half your friends will argue it. That's why the video we're making right now, You could call it fact and fiction. That's why we're making it. Because most people don't get it. They miss it. But the ignorance, most times, and the cockiness, because it's, let's face it, what audience it is, that crew is, they know some, but this is new. So here's my encouragement. Hopefully my energy isn't over the top, and I don't sound like a complete punk and jerk. That's not the goal. The goal is, I know what this does. I've drank this over 3,000 times. It's completely metamorphosed my life. Like, it just has. I'm not going to tell you anything about why it has. I just look and feel like a completely different person. And we have hundreds of thousands of people and millions of servings of this that's gone out into the marketplace. So if you're not with us, get on board, dude. Get on board. Quit being silly. Quit acting cool. Quit acting smart. And if you are cool and smart, that's great. Then you would know what this is. Take a couple of minutes and scratch your opinion and start getting an experience. If you haven't drank it every day for 5 or 10 or 30 days, then I don't want to hear what you think about it. If you haven't read 1 or 2 or 3 hours worth of the real research and content by any one of the thought leaders in the world, pick any one. Doesn't matter the topic. Doesn't matter. Fitness, muscle preservation, weight loss, endurance, fat loss, epilepsy, choose any topic in the world and ketosis along with it or ketone supplementation, that's it. Like, I've just read a lot. I've listened to a lot. I've listened to a lot of podcasts and a lot of thought leaders share what their views are on ketosis. You don't have to make medical claims and even talk about anything at all. Just give people an experience. So if you have an opinion and you're sharing it, hold the opinion, get an experience, and then feed that information back. Drink it. Test your blood. Drink it. Do VO2 max testing. Drink it. Go run 30 miles. Drink it. Go surfing. Drink it. Go to Disneyland with your kids. Drink it and do whatever that is you do that's important in your life. And then tell me what your experience was like. Don't not drink it and then tell me it works or doesn't work. That's like telling me Costa Rica sucks and you've never been here, because what you know about Costa Rica is you got to swim through crocodiles to get here. You don't anymore. You can fly an airplane. So get you some ketones, man. That's it.